Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. I am Richard Evans. Make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. Today I want to show you a few TriCaster advanced recording techniques. Within TriCaster, there are many different ways to record mix outputs and individual channels, and in today's video, I will show you some of these and the details associated with them. So, as usual, let me show you how it's done, son. All right, so we're gonna start off in the TriCaster 2 interface, and I wanna show you where you can go to do the basic recording configuration of the different mixes of your TriCaster. So to do that, we'll go to our program output window, which is this window over here on the right, and click on this gear icon, and that will bring up our output configuration window. Now I'm on the TriCaster 2, and that has 8 different mixes to choose from. Depending on your TriCaster, you could have a variety of different ones. 4 mixes, up to 8 mixes here. VMC has got a bajillion, I don't know. Anyways, so what I want to show you here is, I won't go through all the specifics of the output configuration, but this is where you would go to configure the different mixes coming out of your system. So you can combine different video, audio sources, different resolutions, etc. So let's just say I'm going to do mix number 1's program, and then mix number 2's program clean. But I can choose specific inputs, etc. Okay, and so I have these 8 here, and if I go to the recording tab, this is where I can go to record those 8 mixes. Now, when you set up a session, when you're first starting off, you can determine what you want the resolution of your particular session to be. So if it's 1080, it will record everything in 1080 unless you tell it otherwise. And you can do that by going back over to the output configuration and selecting the resolution here and selecting something different, okay? But let's say that we just have everything set to default here. Let's go through and we can say, change the file name that we want this particular mix to be so that we can identify it later a little bit easier, and then also determine where we want to be recording to, so the different hard drives that are on the machine or a network attached storage. It's kind of up to you. And from there, all you have to do is put a checkbox next to the different recordings once you have them all selected and ready to go, and then go to the top of the screen here and click record, and it will start and stop all of those mix recordings at the same time. So that is the very basic function of the recording capabilities of your TriCasters. But wait, there's a whole lot more. So not only can you record multiple feeds from mixes, but you can also record individual inputs from the input configuration as well. Now, an important note here, when recording directly from an input, that recording will be in the same resolution as the native resolution coming into the session. Now, TriCaster allows you to mix and match different resolutions, which will then turn them all into the same resolution in your mixes only, but leaves the individual channels alone when you're recording. So let's say that you have an input coming in at 4K, but your session is in 1080. The mix recordings will be in 1080, but the ISO recording of that input is going to come in at 4K, which is the native resolution of the input that's coming in. So just an important note to keep in mind. All right, so back in the TriCaster 2 interface, and what I want to show you now is how to record individual channels ISO recorded completely separate from the mix recordings that I just showed you how to do. So I'm going to uncheck this one here, and we have no recordings currently selected. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up input number 4, and let me bring in another source which has audio. So let me go ahead and bring in my source, which is me here in my virtual set, okay? So now you can see that I have some audio bouncing in there, etc. Okay, now to record this particular input just by itself, we'll need to go and click on this button right there, and open up the input configuration for that. Okay, now within here you'll see I have a tab on the input side of things that says capture, and if I put a checkbox next to that, I can now record that one. And I can specify the file name, so Richard Recording, pretty self-explanatory, and then also put in the path that I want to record that particular file in. Okay, now an important note here as well, you'll see that I have audio coming through on this particular input. Let me go ahead and close that and open up my audio mixer. So right now you'll see that I have my input number 4 audio coming in, but it's muted, so it's not showing up in my master audio, aux audio, etc. All right, if I unmute it, it comes out over master, but we're gonna leave that muted for the time being, because what I wanna let you know is, again, whenever you're recording your isolated inputs by themselves, it will, first of all, record them at the native resolution that you were bringing your source in, and it will record the audio that is assigned to the channel that you're coming in on. So input number 4 is only going to be getting my audio. Even if it's muted, it is still going to record it. And that is a great way of keeping everything together. And you can always, because mostly this is going to be used for bringing into, say, post-production work and kind of recutting your show. So if you accidentally don't have audio there, or if it's muted, then you don't have it anymore. So the nice thing is, it is all going to be right here in that channel for you to use. You can just delete it whenever you want, etc. And then once you have that assigned, is recorded and ready to go, all you have to do now is go to the top of the screen and click on record. And as soon as I do that, you'll see over here under my input number 4, I have a recording light, which means now I'm recording this particular input with its native resolution and audio all together in one file. When recording individual channels via Skype, Teams, Live Call Connect, etc., there is an important note here. TriCaster again records those files via their native resolution and native audio, as I mentioned before. So, if the resolution changes during that recording, another file is going to be created from when that resolution changes. Now, this is important to note when bringing in remote contributors. Let's say with a remote call, if the connection rate changes or something drops, etc., during the show, sometimes that application will send a different resolution video signal in order to maintain that connection instead of just hanging up the call. So there is a potential to have a couple of different files associated with a remote call. Now, TriCaster will record all the video and audio, so you're not going to miss a thing, but it will create another file. Now, the next thing that I want to talk to you about is recordings per drive. Since TriCaster records full resolution files that can be pretty large, and we typically recommend when recording to physical hard drives, only 2 recordings per drive. However, this all changes when using either a network-attached drive, like a NewTek remote storage system, or a TriCaster 2 Elite when utilizing the drive speed test feature. Let's take a quick review of that feature. All right, so we are back into the TriCaster 2 Elite interface, and what I want to show you now is the drive speed test. So whenever you're recording a particular broadcast on other TriCasters, for example, we highly recommend only doing 2 recordings per drive. But on the TriCaster 2 Elite, you have a whole bunch of different options, some new hardware and a new software feature, so you can test different drive speeds. Okay, so you'll see over here in my recording side of things, my recording tab, I have my mix number 1, and over next to the file name and path is I have this little speed gauge icon, which is what's going to launch the drive speed test. Now you can access this from any of the mixes or the input capture windows as well. All right, so we click on that. Here is a drive speed test, okay? Now if I click on this drop down, I can then do a drive speed test on not only my internal drives, but also external drives, even my NewTek remote storage that I have attached here, etc. And then I can go and determine how much space I have on those drives, how much time I can record to those, etc. Okay? Now I've already run this drive speed test and you can see the results here. If I wanted to record in 4K 60p, I can record 44 streams simultaneously to my D drive and have 4 hours and 4 minutes per recording, which is pretty awesome and also a little coincidental. I don't know how that happened. All right, and then also if I wanted to record at 1080 60p, I have 44 streams that I can record and then 7 hours and 41 minutes for me to record on that as well. And again, you can test every single drive on your system, and that makes things super convenient. There's no more guesswork. You just hit record and you are able to dust your hands and have a good show. Lastly, you can also record a smaller MP4 file as well, and that feature lives in a very specific place that I will show to you right now. And we are back in the TriCaster 2 interface to show you how to record an MP4 file. All right, so let me go ahead and close this drive speed test, and let me go back into the output configuration tab to show you something in here. So the the ability to record in MP4 is going to live within the streaming encoder, okay? So this is going to be now assigned to one of our streaming mixes here within the output configuration. So keep that in mind. Now I'm going to leave my stream number one assigned to my mix one, which is my program feed. But let's say I want to have my streaming number two. I'm going to assign that to my mix number two, which is program clean. Okay, now this will make a difference here in a second. Let me show you why. Let me go ahead and close this. And I'm going to open up my streaming encoder options up here at the top of the screen. All right, and then you will see over here on the left column, this column here is going to be for the different CDNs that I want to be streaming to. So for example, I'll put a checkbox next to Facebook, YouTube, Periscope, etc. And then over here on the right, I have another streaming encoder as well. Now I do, underneath these defaults, I have an option for file capture, and it will also be under these presets as well. You can do file capture here, okay? And that will allow you to record an MP4. So I'll go ahead and put a checkbox next to file capture here, which is under 2, which was my streaming encoder number 2, okay? Let me go ahead and uncheck these so I don't accidentally stream me babbling to our different social media sites here. What you can do now, let me go ahead and click on the gear icon for that. This is where you would go to then put in the file name and also where you want to have that recorded to, etc. All right. Now, this particular file here, like I said, it's an MP4, and it's just going to be coming from whatever streaming encoder that you have on that particular system. If you want to go through and make some changes, so let's say that our particular session is in 1080, but you want to have an itty-bitty file, what you can do is go up here under your configuration, click on the encoder button for that, and then you can use these different presets to then choose between these different resolutions, or you can type it in manually depending on how you want to do it. So whenever you want to have a configure your MP4 file, this is the tab to go through and do that, and that way you don't have to go through and export this after the fact. You can just record it right then and there and have yourself a nice little MP4 file. All right, and then to start recording it, let's go ahead and close that. Don't click on record here because it was configured under streaming. Go ahead and click stream here. And now you are streaming out to all of your different platforms and recording an MP4 file at the same time. So as you can see, there's a lot of different ways to record your footage and a few different ways to handle these files. I've made a few mistakes in the past on this, which I treat as a learning experience, which I then turn those learning experiences into teachable moments and turn those teachable moments into tutorial videos like this one to share with y'all. Now, if you'd like to see more tutorial videos like this one, subscribe to the New Tech YouTube channel at youtube.com/newtechinc. For formal New Tech product training, check out New Tech University, which you can find at newtech.com/newtech-u. And for more information about New Tech products and services, talk to your local reseller, or you can visit our website, newtech.com. And as always, if you're posting your work on social media, tag us using the hashtags NewTech or TriCaster. You'll see my name pop up in your likes for sure. Now, I hope this video was informative. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon for another edition of... Wait for it. New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. Thanks, guys.